with me for the hour is the jewel in the crown of Mark Dolan tonight, especially on Saturdays. It's the queen of US showbiz, royal and political reporting here in London, Kinsey Schofield. Kinsey, great to see you face to face.
That's some of the intro to my reel, you saying that. That's how important you are to me.
Well, vice versa, and to our viewers and listeners, we love checking in with you every Saturday night when we talk about royal stories. We talk about American politics as well, and Joe Biden, all the rest of it.
Yes.
But no politics for the next couple of days. This is a royal celebration.
Absolutely. And normally I am watching you at home cackling at you, so it is so hard to sit next to you and not laugh out loud. That was an amazing monologue.
Oh, bless you. Well, I don't think there was anything remotely controversial in there.
Let's talk about... Do you remember when Diana called her Rottweiler? It's not just horse face. She really took some tough hits.
Well, that's right. And this is why you struggle to reconcile this new royal marriage with what happened in the past, because you are a Diana loyalist. Your podcast is called To Die For Daily. Your website is todiefordaily.com.
Yeah.
And if I can get a little shot of this, this is the book, which is now a bestseller. And it is called R is for Revenge Dress.
Yes.
A Princess Diana-inspired alphabet book for grown-ups, right? It's doing really well.
Thank you.
And you are in Team Diana. So do you struggle with my positive words about Camilla?
I don't, because I do think towards the end of Diana's life, she started to recognize that love, authenticity between Charles and Camilla. In fact, they say that she said to Prince William, pursue that love. Pursue that's true love. You know, obviously I'm hurt by the way that everything came to fruition, and it's why Diana's not here anymore, truly. But I respect their relationship, and I sincerely believe that they're soulmates, like you said in your monologue.
Yes, I mean, you're so knowledgeable about Princess Diana. You've loved her since you were a little girl. Can you give us a sense of the turmoil she went through having to coexist with three people in that marriage, as she puts it?
She was desperately in love with Prince Charles. And I do think that she was in love not only with Prince Charles, but the idea of being this princess that could inevitably become the queen one day. And, you know, she knew she was beautiful and youthful and popular, and I think it ate her up inside, comparing herself to Camilla and struggling to determine what she had that Diana didn't. And, I mean, it literally did eat her up inside. She had multiple eating disorders and mental health issues. So I ache when I think about those instances, and I think that that's why you see Prince William so aggressively champion mental health today.
And who do you see as the villain of the piece here? Is it Camilla herself, or was it Charles for taking this mistress?
That's such a hard question, because
she was married to
Andrew Parker Bowles, but Andrew Parker Bowles never stopped dating.
Right, he was a philanderer, so there was no point her being loyal.
But he got an invite to the wedding, so good for him.
The
coronation. Yeah, the coronation. He got an invite to the coronation. Who's the bad guy? I do think that Charles knew that it was monarchy over everything, and when you take a mistress so and reckless things start to happen, negative headlines, you are putting the monarchy in jeopardy. If I had to pick a bad guy, I hate to pick a bad guy, but I'd say Charles should know better. And we know that Queen Elizabeth and Prince Philip sat down with him and tried to set him straight about that, and he chose to pursue love.
Have you forgiven Camilla?
I have forgiven Camilla, because I do think that the media was horrible to her at the time, and she kept quiet. She kept, you know, she just stayed by Charles's side, and I think she was in it for the right reasons.
And she's played a blinder, really, since she came out publicly with Prince Charles. I can't think of a single gaffe, really.
No, I don't think so at all. I can think of Charles has had a few, but I think that she has stayed pretty low-key. And in doing so, I think a lot of people have gained respect for her.
Okay. Well, look, what's your appraisal of Queen Camilla? Do you think she'll be a good queen? Do you share my enthusiasm for her reign? Is she your queen? Mark at gbnews.uk.